which is known to the commissioners already on January 18 because I gave them my separate opinion.
Okay.
To DQ Marcos Jr. So to defeat my vote, Commissioner Ferolino is delaying the release of her potentia so that if it comes out after February 2, then they are thinking, whoever is conspiring with her, that my vote will not be counted. So I released it. I said it to the public that this is the reason for the delay.
Who do you think is conspiring with, if at all, if indeed this is happening, who do you think is conspiring with Commissioner Ferolino regarding this?
That's a very important case. I think there's somebody very powerful that's backing her up. Because, you know, she's a new commissioner. She's not practiced law in the court. So she's not, you know, trained in writing decisions or pleading. So I gave her some allowance for that. You know, it's not easy for some people to write. But, you know, you wanted to become commissioner. I presume you should have known that half of the work will be writing decisions, right?
Okay.
So who
is this powerful politician that you're talking about?
I think it's already unreasonable. I think even with her slow pace, she could have finished this in 15 days.
Okay. Commissioner Guanzon, who do you think is this powerful politician allegedly influencing her?
Well, I'm not going to name the person yet because it's not yet time. Maybe Commissioner Ferolino might just release her ponencia on Monday or Tuesday. You know, let's give her a few more days.
But if she doesn't?
Well, we'll see. We'll get there.
Okay. But you already know who this politician is.
Yes. I have a strong hunch already who it is. And actually, that's why Spokesman Secretary Panelo already came out with his statement today in GMA News.
What
exactly? The president does not want to interfere. Does not interfere. And if there are people close to him, he's worried that it might reflect at they might say it's the president's doing.
So if it's not coming from the side of the president, you were also quoted as saying that this is coming from a particular group with no candidate for president in 2022. The reasonable conclusion would be the PDP Laban wing.
It could be them. But what's important is that I said already, they should stop influencing the commissioners. But now it's too late. They have already influenced, in my opinion. There is this unreasonable delay is no longer due to the slow pace of, what do you call this, writing abilities of Commissioner Ferolino. Because she did not take any effort to explain to me why she cannot deliver. On January 24, she had no time. I cannot promise that I can release it this week. So I told the other commissioner. So when is she going to release it? Out next week after I retire? She is aware that I'm going to retire. What kind of answer is that? You cannot promise that you can submit it this week. What do you mean? It means that you have no commitment at all to your presiding commissioner when you will release your ponencia. Pwede ba yan?
Okay. In another interview, you mentioned a senator who could be behind this delay or trying to influence this.
It's not Senator Marcos. No, it's not.
But it's a senator. But is it a senator?
She will not do that.
But were you referring to a senator?
You know, Amy was my classmate. She won't do that to me. She's very respectful. Actually, the Marcoses are very respectful. I don't know why BBM released his attack dogs.
Okay.
But the Marcoses are really not vindictive by personality, you know? No.
Okay. We'll go to the attacks against you by this lawyer, Attorney Briones. But before we go to
You know who he is? You know who he is?
Yeah.
He's not a practicing lawyer.
Ganun po
ba? He wasn't in COA for a long time. He's my fraternity brother.
Okay.
Now ayaw na niya. He doesn't want to debate with me anymore.
Okay. Pupuntahan po natin mamaya yun, yung mga allegations against you.
Why he should he backed off because he remembered this sixth code in Sigmaron.
Okay.
Because if he violates his sixth code, I will ask the alumni to expel him.
Okay. So you already cleared Senator Aimee Marcos. Sabi niyo hindi niya gagawin to, no? But you are sure that it is a senator trying to influence this?
Most probably, yes.
Ano po yung basis?
Because she's close to a senator, eh.
Ano po yung basis?
Because she's very close to a senator who supported her appointment.
Ano po yung basis nitong hunch nyo na this powerful politician is a senator?
I don't live in a cave. So let's move to the next question.
So, pero sure kayo na meron. We just want to ascertain the...
I already said that. That is the basis why I came out. Because there is already malicious delay.
Okay. Ang claim naman ni Commissioner Ferolino, there was no such internal agreement among the three members of the First Division.
Yeah, but there is a rules eh. If she's reading the rules, it says there very clearly, no later than 15 days. You should release your resolution no later than 15 days. Isn't she studying the rules? If she, even if she denies the 7-day period, that's not true, huh? Because our chief attorneys know the rules, the internal agreement. We made that internal agreement because that has always been the agreement in the First Division before she arrived. And then when I went to Bacolod, and I stayed there for 2 years because of the pandemic, with more reason that I asked the two of them to release their drafts in 7 days, because it takes time to send it to Bacolod and I'll sign it and send it back. So we have been complying with that. If she thinks that is not reasonable, isn't 15 days what her deadline?
Okay.
It's now 18 days instead of her writing a 3-page letter to the chairman. Why doesn't she just sit down and write her ponencia?
How would you respond to her claim that it is you trying to influence her and the other member of the division to vote against Marcos?
Just because I sent out my separate opinion on January 17? You know, do you know the normal, what do you call this? Dynamics of the commissioners. Commissioner Ferolino comes to me when she needs something. In fact, before January 17, she came to my office more than 1 hour. We chatted because we were friends. I supported her when she was election officer. When she was about to be suspended, I objected and I told them, you just fine her. When she applied for provincial supervisor, I was the one who nominated her. She cannot say that this is personal.
Okay.
No, that's not true that we did not agree on it, because she was there in my office with her brother, in fact, her chief of staff, for more than 1 hour. And we talked about this and I said, okay, the hearing will be so-and-so. Will you attend? That's good, you'll attend. So she was in the preliminary conference. She already heard the admissions. In fact, she was also irked that Marcos was a no-show and the lawyer was, a cavalier about it. Okay. And, we could have declared them in default.
Ipaliwanag rin po natin sa mga... Let's also explain to the viewers the idea of... a separate opinion, because iniisip ng iba, is this a separate dissenting opinion or a separate concurring opinion?
I sent my separate opinion because I don't even know what her vote will be. And I don't even know what the vote of Commissioner Casquejo will be. But since I'm retiring, I wanted my separate opinion out already. Because, I write very fast. Do you know I've written at least 7 books? I mean, real books. I mean... I'm really a prolific writer. My mind works even when I'm asleep. So what I did is I said, let's get over this. I want to write my separate opinion. And I released it on that day because that was our, agreed date that we would meet in the office and, she would have a draft by then, but she did not show up. I'm not, you mean by releasing a separate opinion, I'm trying to influence them? Ano ba sila? Batang maliliit? Di ba may pag-iisip naman sila? They're doing it, my golly. Even if I send you 100-page separate opinion, you have your own mind. You should know. You went to law school. You practice law, I hope. You can assess the evidence if there is moral turpitude or not.
Okay.
Golly.
Okay, well, Commissioner.
Did I put a gun in her head? Did I put a gun in her head and told her you sign your resolution now? Of course not. Is it wrong for me to issue a separate opinion? No, of course not.
Okay. Now, speaking of the separate opinion, what do you make of this statement by Attorney Briones? Kasi may binanggit siya rin sa statement niya. Sabi niya,
you're... Si Briones.
Hindi, tanungin ko muna kasi napaka-importante nito.
Hindi nga po. Sabi ko sa'yo, si Briones dapat talaga umarap sa akin sa debate eh. Kasi he's diverting the issue here. Okay. Hindi ka na makasali dito, Brad, sa usapan natin ng gulo-gulo dito, nang gugulo ka eh. Abogado ka lang eh. Gusto mo eh, pakontempt kita, pakulong kita eh. Yung kliyente nyo, may pending pa sa akin. I'm the presiding commissioner. You call me narcissistic. Ikaw, ano ka? Do not call me narcissistic. Papayag pa ako. Sabihin mo sa ako na I am insane. Sabihin mo na I am insane.
Okay. So would you do that?
No. What do you call this? No, not a rated lawyer. Yeah, I should not be answering his remarks. He's not a rated lawyer. He's not even a judge.
Okay, pero would you cite him in contempt because of this?
No, he's my brother. Eh. Ipapadal na lang siya ng pegot sa layo ng mga sis.
Okay. Pero ito nga, may sinabi siya na yung...
Ayaw niya na mag-debate sa akin eh.
Opo.
Pero... Kasi yung six coach eh. Sis mo ako, senior sis mo ako. I'm most senior sis in government aside from Senator Pierredano. Briones, you call me narcissistic? If I file a libel suit against you in Bacolod, maglalakad ka sa gitna ng mga tubo.
Okay.
Brad, kita, kaya siguro tinatawanan lang kita kasi yung lit-lit mo eh. Hanggang tenga lang kita eh.
Okay. Kung hindi nyo pa po alam yung decision ng kasama nyong mga commissioners sa First Division, pero bakit ang sabi ni Briones, yung decision nyo raw, minority decision opinion?
Eh, wag ko sa kanya. Ibig sabihin, alam niya na may nasuhulan siya. May nasuhulan ba siya? Bakit alam niya na minority yung akin? Alam niya na yung boto ng dalawa, kontra? You catch the fish in the mouth. Bakit? Okay. May nasuhulan na ba kayo? May tumanggap ba ng pera?
What do you think?
Yan, tanong ko sa kanila.
Okay.
Did money change hands? How come you know that mine is a minority opinion?
Okay.
That the majority is in favor of your whatever client.
Nangyari lang iniisip na marami. Ano niya nasabi ng minority opinion?
Sabi ko separate opinion eh because I did not know their votes yet. Wala pang resolution. Wala pang punensya. How can mine be a dissenting opinion? Hindi nga Briones, hindi nag-practice ng lawyer eh. Matagal yan sa PhilCOA kay JPE. Sumbong kita kay JPE ha. Tawag mo ako narcissistic ha. Ikaw, Napoleonic complex ka. Kaya may inferiority complex ka kasi maliit ka eh.
Okay.
Oh. At hindi ka pa guwapo. Ano ngayon?
Okay.
Alam mo, Mr. Isguera, I can speak English much better than you if I want and you know it. Dinatagalan ko dito kasi bastusan na to eh.
Okay.
Bastusan na to. Baka nakalimutan nyo, nag-mayor ako.
Okay.
Ng Warlord City ng Cadiz. Oh. 27 anyos lang ako. Sagutin ko yung mga tanong nyo na tama. Huwag yung mga tanong nyo na narcissistic ako. Kulang nyo lang sabihin nyo na baliw ako eh.
Can
you imagine that I can write all these things and I am mentally ill?
Okay. Let's go to the other issue that they raise against you. Yung the fact that you made your opinion public, they claim that this should not have been done.
It is Commissioner Ferulino who may be liable under Section 3C of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Why? Because she's delaying the release of a resolution to favor a litigant. That is an impeachable offense. Sinasalang si Commissioner Ferulino dito ng bago-bago po siyang commissioner. Sirang-sira na yung tingin ng marami sa mata ko sa kanya. Wala na akong respeto sa kanya. Sinira niyo lahat ng mga samahan namin ni Commissioner Ferulino dahil lang sa inyo. Mga saw-saw kayo. Kaya ikaw, George Briones, magpaliwanag ka sa alumni, ha? Bakit mo ako tinawag na narcissistic, ha? Narcissist mo ako. Sige, Mr. Esguera, next question.
Okay, have you ever gotten in touch with Commissioner Ferulino after this? No. Nagkausap na ba kayo o hindi pa rin?
The last text nga was 24. So I told Commissioner Casqueo, why don't you be the one to call her? You tell her if she cannot do it, she can waive it and you can take it over, even if I know you're also very busy. But at least we have an assurance that it will be released before my retirement. Okay. But she did not reply to to Commissioner Casqueo. So in executive session, I told the chair and the commissioners my problem. And so I asked the chair that he should be the one to call Commissioner Ferolino and perhaps she will answer. Yeah. Instead, she issues a memorandum explaining her delay, at the same time attacking me for wanting publicity. Ayun na naman mi, Commissioner Ferolino. Sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan eh. Sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan. Hindi ko na kailangan ng publicity. Gusto okay. ko lang, mag-retire ako with honor, integrity, and excellence. Okay. Hindi yung pinababoy nyo yung presiding commissioner nyo. What, you are disrespecting me? You have no respect for me as your senior commissioner and presiding commissioner. Okay. If I had more than 5 days to now, be in COMELEC, I'm really going to make you account for this discourtesy. She's okay. already...
Commissioner.
Ferolino makes it appear that she's the victim here. No, okay. The people are the victim here.
Okay, you made that clear, no? Pero given this...
My vote can be counted.
Okay, given this back and forth...
Too, so that my vote will be counted.
Okay, you made that clear, no? So, given this back and forth between you and Commissioner Ferolino, how do you think this could affect whatever decision would ultimately come out? Kasi baka naman magkaroon na talaga ng duda.
Whatever the outcome is. Whatever decision will come out, will go up anyway on motion for reconsideration. And then we'll go up anyway to Supreme Court. I keep on telling all these Marcos loyalists, you know. It is to your benefit na. It's in everybody's benefit and interest that this case goes up to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. Why? What if Bongbong Marcos is DQ'd by the Supreme Court, you know, 1 week before elections? Who will he substitute? How will he substitute campaign? What if he is DQ'd by the Supreme Court after the elections and he has not substituted?
Okay.
He will not be able to assume office. What if he wins but he was DQ'd? He will be removed from office. That is why it is better that this case goes to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. It is in the nation's interest. Why are you okay. holding your resolution there as if that is the final?
Let's go to your basis, the arguments or the basis that you cited in your opinion to disqualify Bongbong Marcos. Sabi niyo maliwanag, it's a crime that involved moral turpitude. But others were claiming na it's very difficult to determine whether that particular crime, non-filing of ITR for 4 years, constituted a crime of involving moral turpitude. How did you arrive at that?
Let the Supreme Court decide this so that I will know if I am right or wrong. Huh? How can you be more scholarly than I am? Can you claim to be smarter than I am in the law and jurisprudence? No lawyer here, except justices of the Supreme Court, can claim that they can read the law better than me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by golly. Let's have a debate on national TV. Even Briones already backed out because he does not meet the height requirement.
Okay. So, yun nga, how did you determine that, yung moral turpitude, when others were claiming na hindi raw siya ganun kaliwanag?
Tell me. Very simple things. Way, simple lang na tao dyan, no? Tricycle driver, tanungin mo. Yung matanda na sabi nila nagnakaw ng 10 kilong mangga, kinulong nila. Moral turpitude, pag nanakaw. Sa Australia, traffic violation, moral turpitude. They will cancel your application for citizenship. Moral turpitude. Traffic violation lang ha. Nag one-way street ka lang. Dito sa Pilipinas, ibig mo sabihin, hindi ka nag-file ng income tax return, 4 beses bilang gobernador ng Ilocos at ang presidente at diktador ay ama mo, hindi pa yon moral turpitude. Tanungin mo batang maliit na magaling ang pagpalaki na magulang, Goodbye yan ako, bad. Ay, bad yan. Hindi siya nagbayad eh. Utang yan sa gobyerno eh. And he was convicted. Convicted! Marcos Jr. is convicted. He's a convict. How many times do I have to say that he's a convict? He was convicted twice in the regional trial court and in the court of appeals. But he did not pay the fine. He did not even bother to pay the fine. So how am I supposed to help him, even if he's the brother of my seatmate, Aimee Marcos? How can I help him in some way when that is everything that he did is on record admitted by his lawyers? I cannot find any legal justification for his actions. I cannot conclude but say that all of those failure to file income tax returns for 4 years and failure to fine, to pay the fine in regional trial court, were intentional. Were intentionally done with a cavalier attitude, being the son of the president who thought that he was above the law.
So you made that very clear, which reminds me, when we interviewed the attorney Briones before, he was very somehow cavalier about it as well. Ang claim niya, in the non-payment of, non-filing of ITRs for 4 years, wala rong pinagkaiba, it's as simple as jaywalking. So that was her attitude at that time, jaywalking lang daw, parang jaywalking lang daw yan.
Nagnakaw nga ang tao, 10 kilong mangga ay kinulong nila. Ito, bali pag nanakaw din ito ng buwis sa gobyerno 4 taon, ito hindi nagbayad ng multa, hindi ito moral turpitude. Ay, pambihira naman. Ano bang reasonable na standard lang po ito, attorney? Summary procedure, summary lang ang COMELEC. Hindi po kami criminal case na beyond reasonable doubt ang standard. Substantial evidence lang po, pambira naman kayo. Kasi hindi naman kayo nagpa-practice sa COMELEC eh. Never naman kayo nag-appear dyan sa amin. Hirap naman na nagpapanggap kayong expert kayo. Wala naman kayong alam sa election, no? Ah, estudyante ko kayo, ilang beses na kayo na 5 isang araw.
Okay,
and that note. Tumigil na attorney Briones. You let attorney Rodriguez speak for his client. Saw-saw itong partido mo na di naman kayo kasali. Contempt na kita pag nainis ako sa'yo eh. Bukas, contempt na kita.
Okay, and that note, thank you very much, Commissioner Rowena Guanzon, for joining us tonight. Good luck on your retirement on February 2.
Alam nyo, kawawa lang si George Briones eh. Sinalang nyo lang dito para may diversionary tactic eh, which is very bad. I can see what you are doing. Let's focus on the question of Commissioner Ferolino, when are you going to release your Ponentia resolution?
Yeah, actually, nasagot nyo na po yan. So
release it before February 2 so that I can attach my vote and separate opinion.
Yeah.
If you do not do so, you may be liable under Section 3C. Of the Anti-Graft on Corruption and Corrupt Practices Act, which may be an impeachable offense.
Okay.
Thank you very much, mga kababayan.
Thank you for making that clear. Thank you for joining us tonight, Commissioner Guanzon.
Thank you very much.